Hello, good morning all. Today in this video, we are going to discuss regarding how to write access right for your custom model. So in the previous video, we have discussed about how to create menu, how to create a Minto action, and how to link menu and action. So we all have done all those things, but still our menu is not visible over here. So I told it's due to access right error, and we have bypassed it using the super user mode. So if I go to settings and I'll keep the developer mode activated, so you can see still our menu and its action is not visible over here, and it get visible once we activate super user mode to bypass the access right. So you can see it get visible in the super user mode. So initially it's not getting visible because we haven't set any access rights for the newly created model, that is hospital.patient. That is why it's not getting visible without super user mode. So if I go to settings, then to the technical, and if I scroll down, you will see a menu named security. So you can see security, we have record rules and access right. So right now I'm talking about access right, and we will come back to the record rules later in this Odoo 15 tutorials. So access rights. So what we have to do, we have to define access rights for our custom model, that is hospital.patient. So what I'll do is that in order to exit the super user mode, so right now you can see it's Odoo bot, that is super user mode. So in order to exit super user mode, you have to log out and log in again. So I log in again in admin, and you can see, let me refresh, still the hospital is getting visible, not sure, maybe the cache issue or something. So let me log out and let me log in again. So you can see we are not able to access. You can see you are getting an error. So we have to define the security for this model. So what I will do, first of all, I'll uninstall this module. So you can see OIM hospital is installed, and I'll click on uninstall. So this is just to show you something. I'll uninstall this module from the database. So it has been uninstalled, and I'll go to the apps, and I'll click on module info, and I'll clear the log. So here, you know, this is the log section. I'll just click on delete. So the log is empty now, and I'll come back here and click on install. And if you check the log, you can see there is a warning. The model hospital.patient have no access rule in module OIM hospital. Consider adding a security, and Odoo is providing us the security line. So you can see in the log itself, they are asking us to, or they are suggesting us to add the security or access rule for the model hospital.patient. So we have to add that. So I'll go to custom add-ons folder. Here we have our OIM hospital module. So all the security, this is a Odoo guideline, all the security related files we will be placing in a folder called security. So yes, we have to create a new directory, and I'll name it as security. So as we are going to add security file, I'm creating a new directory called security, and inside this you have to create a file new and name it as ir.model.access.csv. Click on OK. Okay, so you have to create an ir.model.access.csv file inside the security folder, because if you may get doubt why we have to give this name ir.model.access.csv. So if you come back to the UI, and if I go to settings, technical, scroll down until you see access rights, and if I open, check this model name. The model name is ir.model.access. So this is the name .csv. We are going to load data in the CSV format. That's why .csv given. So this is the model name. We have to load data to this model, ir.modelAccess. So the model name is given .csv. So just create such a file. Then from your Odoo log, you can copy this. Copy this, Control C, and just paste it over here. So if you check this, so this is a suggestion that we got from the logger, log section. So you have to provide an ID, first line showing the header, like ID, first one is ID, then name, then we will be specifying model, then we will be specifying group, then permission read, permission write, permission, like these are ID. Like if I move this, we have written two lines of code here. So first line will be read as a header level, just to identify first column contain ID, then followed by name, then after comma, it will be model, after comma, it will be group, then permission. So these are Boolean fields, whether to show, to grant or not. Read permission, we can provide one, if not, put zero. So I'll give the ID, OIM hospital. I'll just remove this ID. I'll use a different format, access hospital.patient. You can give the name like this, access.hospitalPatient. Then you have to, this is ID, first value will goes to ID, comma, then you have to give a name. Name should be access hospital patient. Then you have to specify the model name. So model name, you have to specify as follows, module name dot model underscore. So the syntax to specify the model name is module name dot model. Underscore, then you have to specify the model name, hospital patient. So you can see this syntax here, module name is OIM hospital, model underscore hospital dot patient. Then if you have some user group, you can assign this. So you can see right now base dot group user means internal user. So if I search for this user group inside the Odoo source code, you can see it is internal group, internal user. So I'm just granting this permission, just grant permission for this internal user, because we have like portal users, etc. So they don't need any access. So just give this user group, or if you don't understand, just keep it empty. Keep it empty means no value. So you can do like this. I'll provide that user group. And read permission, read one means I'm granting read permission. Yeah, I'll grant write permission. I'll grant create permission and I'll grant delete permission. So all the permission has been granted. So this is just a basic video on security. You have to give this actually based on how your system should be designed, like what all permission should be received by different levels of user. So don't worry about that. In the later part of this Odoo 15 tutorials, we'll be making a separate video on access rights. So for this, you can just understand this is how you can add security for a model. So we have specified model name, patient, group, and given the access right. So we have successfully added this file. Now we have to add this file inside or load this file inside manifest. So here in the data file, before the views, you have to load this security file also. Slash, copy the name, put it over here, put a comma. So mostly people will forget, like when we add, they'll forget to add this comma. If you do so, you will be getting error and then you have to come back again and fix. So just don't forget to add this comma after each line. So we have done that. So we have created file and imported in the manifest file. So just restart the service. Now we will go to the UI, and right now if you go to the models folder, so before upgrading, I'll go to the models folder and let me search for patient and let me open this model. And if you check the access rights tab, right now it's empty. So I'll just duplicate this tab and I'll upgrade or install. So it's already installed. So I'll upgrade the OIM hospital module in the database. So you can see it has been successfully installed. So just while installing the module, just watch the log file. If you have any something missing, Odoo will suggest you over here. So just keep an eye on the log section while you install your module. So it's done. Now what we will do, we'll go to the UI, and if you refresh the screen, in the access rights tab, you can see it has been added access, hospital patient, user, internal user, the group, read, write, create, and delete. All the permission has been granted. You can see access rights has been added. And if you go to access right menu also here, and if you search for hospital, you will see this rule over here. Now you can see hospital. Earlier it was not getting visible, and once it get visible and on clicking, it was showing error. But right now, if you click on this, there is no error. So this is how you can define access rights for a model in Odoo. So what we have done is created a new folder, because security will be placed inside security folder. Name it as ir.modelaccesscsv. Return the rule, imported it inside the manifest file. So when you are writing or importing data, security file has to be imported first. So you can see I haven't written it at the last. I didn't write it at the last. I write it at the top, because it's the order. First we have to load security, then views. So I hope you understood this video. If you have any doubts, feedbacks, or suggestions, don't hesitate to share it with us. You can directly have a comment under this video, or you can share it in the email, that is odoomates@gmail.com, and feel free to connect us in the social medias like LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. So that's it for the day. Have a nice day. Thank you.